Intercity travel still not allowed in Metro Manila despite a shift to looser quarantine classification. Police say only authorized persons working in another city or municipality or those with medical emergencies will be allowed to pass through the borders.
Pagbabasihan natin itong mga guidance ito para ipatupad dyan sa aming pagbabantay sa mga checkpoint sa iba't ibang lugar kung saan pupunta ang ating mga kabayan. At siguraduhin na kung sila ay allowed lumabas, they observing the minimum public health standard.
Religious gatherings also remain prohibited during the modified enhanced community quarantine. Some malls have meanwhile adjusted their operating hours as more retail stores are allowed to reopen.
The city of Tubigarao in Cagayan to remain under the strictest lockdown classification for another week. That's as COVID-19 cases there continue to surge, according to the mayor. Tubigarao had already been placed under a 10-day enhanced community quarantine. Active cases in the city spiked by more than 500 during that period. The Cagayan Valley Medical Center in Tubigarao nearing full capacity after it logged a record high of 295 COVID patients. The office of the vice president also getting overwhelmed by the number of calls it's getting for its teleconsultation program. The OVP says inquiries went up by 400% this past week alone, from 100 calls a day to 400.
Si BP mismo, Kaeli, lagi yung nag-graveyard shift. Simula alas 11 or midnight, nakatutok na po yan sa emergency thread namin, tsaka sa LGU referral thread, para kung meron talagang emergency na mangyari, kailangan i-facilitate agad sa hospital or itawag sa local government unit para rumisponde at makatugon dun sa pangangailangan ng pamilya or pasyente.
The Philippines logged 16,044 new COVID-19 infections Sunday, bringing the nationwide tally to more than 1,839,000. Active cases stand at 125,900. The Okta Research Group warns the country could see a daily caseload of 20,000 a day over the next 2 weeks, citing high reproduction rates in areas outside Metro Manila. The health department earlier said it already assumes there is community transmission of the more contagious COVID-19 Delta variant in the Philippines.
Yung 20,000 cases, mukhang very possible na maabot natin yan within the next 2 weeks, 20,000 cases in one day. So itong 17,000 nakita natin days ago, hindi pa yan yung pinakamataas, hindi pa yan yung peak.
215 more deaths were reported, the fourth day in a row that new fatalities topped 200. The lower house hoping to mediate between PhilHealth and hospitals after medical groups threatened to disengage from the state-run health insurer. That's following a new PhilHealth circular temporarily suspending payments to healthcare providers with questionable claims. Hospitals and doctors claim the move is just a ploy to further delay pending payments to health facilities, amounting to around 86 billion pesos. The House Committee on Health is set to hold a dialogue with the two sides tomorrow to discuss the matter. Committee Chair Quezon Representative Helen Tan hopes to resolve the issue immediately as the country battles a COVID-19 surge. Senator Bongo, chairman of the Senate Health Committee, says he has also reached out to both parties and called for a possible reconciliation.
Navota City sees a slowdown in its COVID-19 vaccination drive. Navota's Mayor Toby Chanco explains health workers in his city are stretched thin from having to work in inoculation sites and hospitals.
Ikukumpara natin yung rate of vaccination nung pumapayag pa tayo ng walk-in at ngayon nabawasan na yan. No? Kasi for example, dati ang isang site natin nakaka-vaccinate siya ng up to 1,000.
Yes.
Noong pwede walk-in. Bumaba siya ng 600. Okay? So may bawas na yun na 400. So tapos babawasan mo pa yung per site ng 600. So kung dalawang site yung nabawas sa amin compared to last week, nabawasan ulit kami ng at least 1,000 doses ng pagbabakuna.
There are now more than 13 million Filipinos fully vaccinated against COVID-19, which makes up around 18% of the government's target by the end of the year.
Let's get an update now on the vaccine rollout in Quezon City from our correspondent, Jervis Mahan. Good morning, Jervis. What more can you tell us?
Yes, good morning, Mike. Around 493,000 or close to 500,000 vaccine doses were administered in Quezon City, the largest city in Metro Manila, in the two-week lockdown imposed from August 6 to August 20. That brings the total number of jabs administered in the city to more than 2.14 million. The local government says they have intensified the vaccination rate, bringing together various schemes like company-assisted and barangay-assisted bookings to inoculate more people as possible. Quezon City aims to vaccinate 1.7 million people, or 80% of its adult population. Of this number, 1.4 million people, or 86.36%, have already received their first doses. 675, or 42%, have been fully vaccinated. Once the 1.7 million target is reached, then population protection will be achieved. But the city vows to continue vaccinating people as long as a vaccine supply is available. Right now, Mike, COVID cases in the city has reached 122,000, of which 8,959 are active cases. The isolation facilities have 80% occupancy rate. Mike.
Jervis, are you hearing any talks about possible booster shots in light of reports that the Delta variant or even potential Lambda variant might be more resistant to vaccines?
Well, there's no such talks as of now, Mike, because the priority of Quezon City is to inoculate more people as possible. So as long as we have not achieved population protection, or as long as we have not vaccinated the target population, then I don't think the booster shots will be available. And Quezon City is also following directives from the IATF.
All right. Thanks for the update, Jervis Manahan.
The Philippine Health Department assures the public COVID-19 vaccines in Central Visayas remain in good condition, despite a power outage that hit the region over the weekend. It says a contingency plan was followed and the vaccines were stored in cold room facilities with backup power generators. On Saturday, parts of Cebu, Bohol, Leyte, and Samar were hit by a blackout, which lasted for at least 5 hours. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines says the power interruption was caused by lightning that struck distribution lines in Cebu.